This is a small presentation that I kind of put together with whatever information that I had about LinkedIn, so that it'll be useful to all of us to have a better understanding of the tool and then use it to the best of our use. Okay, so a couple of assumptions. One, you already have a LinkedIn profile created. I'm not going to go through a process of telling you how to create a LinkedIn profile. Okay, I hope that you already have a LinkedIn profile. And at least you have posted once in LinkedIn. I'm sure that most of you would have done that. It's not a complicated process. You have a text box where you can type whatever and then you just post it. That's it. It's not complicated. So assuming that these two are a yes for you, we'll just go through the agenda of today's session. This session should be over in almost an hour, I think. So the agenda would be what's LinkedIn, a basic introduction to it. What do you mean by connections? So connections is a term that is specific to LinkedIn, I think. So what are connections? What is the target audience? This is something that is not that common across people who use LinkedIn. The other one is how to make your profile a bit better, how to make it searchable, because you're in LinkedIn for being searchable, to connect to others. So how do you make yourself visible is what we'll go through. And the main thing is content. Once you have this, the first four is kind of a one-time job. Content is something that is going to happen the whole of your lifetime in LinkedIn. So this is the agenda. So what's LinkedIn? Basically, LinkedIn is basically a tool which can help you network to get more business. When I say business, it could be multiple things. It could be a business as in a financial thing, or a business in terms of the connections that you have. Your personal connections can also be treated as a business, or building a brand for yourself, getting a job, trying to get people who can work for you, or you want to work for someone else. So LinkedIn is basically a professional network. So that's a main difference between Facebook and LinkedIn. So this is a professional network. Okay, now it can allow you to generate leads relatively cheaply. So when you compare the different networking sites that you have, the amount of money that you have to spend to get a lead for yourself, it's relatively cheap with LinkedIn. Now, recruiters could be using it for getting people for their company or for their customer. There are also people who are using LinkedIn to get new jobs, better jobs, or the first job. Now, treat LinkedIn as a live resume. So a resume, you can put whatever you want, but then LinkedIn is something which adds a bit more authenticity to what you write, because it's out in the public. So you will have your life story as a professional in LinkedIn, and it will be a live document that others can look in and comment on it. Okay, so the other group would be it provides support to you. There are groups which can help you out whenever there is a doubt that you have, any questions you have. There'll be multiple people who will be jumping in to support you. It shows what others think of you. So it's more about when you put your thoughts in LinkedIn, you get an immediate feedback of what others are thinking. So that kind of polishes your thought process. You'll be able to create new ideas by getting those feedback from others. The other one is you can build your personal or business brand. Again, as I said, you can have a brand for yourself. There are people who have their own companies in this audience. So they probably would be creating a brand for themselves and then maybe pushing their business to their prospective clients. So you can do that with LinkedIn. And maybe the last one I would say is maybe news and business post. A lot of news come out, and news that is related with your profession that gets highlighted in LinkedIn. So news, business posts, it can be informative and inspirational. So you'll be able to understand where you should change your direction according to the different data that you get in LinkedIn. So if I have to group it, the first group would be lead generation. You want to get leads for your business. Leads could be, as I said, it could be financial, it could be network, networking with other people, or it could be your brand also. The other one is job search. And the third group would be personal branding. So this is how I would kind of group these definitions of LinkedIn, or the uses of LinkedIn, into these three groups. Now, how to use LinkedIn? That's a very simple question, right? Just log in and then start posting, going around all the posts, watch the videos, that's it, right? So what is so complicated about it? No, it's not that easy. So the most efficient way to use LinkedIn is to have something called connections. Connections is equivalent to friends in other social media, like Facebook. You have friends, you invite someone else to be a friend of yours, and he becomes a friend. Connections are similar in LinkedIn, but since it's a professional site, they don't call it as friends, they call it as connections. Now, there are three different milestones that you can put for the number of connections. So the first milestone that people say is when you get to a 5,000 connection milestone. So zero to connection. When you start the profile, you might not have any connections at all, and you gradually add a lot more connections to your profile and get to a point where you get to 5,000 connections. We'll go to that text in bracket after a minute. So the next milestone would be 30K connections, 5K to 30K. This is because the max number of connections that LinkedIn allows is 30K. And the third one is 30K and above. Now, if you have used LinkedIn, you might have seen two things where you are able to interact with others. One is called connections. There would be a button called connect. And some of the guys will have a button called follow. So I was not very sure what these two were and how it is different. So the difference between connection and follow is when you have a connection, it means that you are having a mutual connection with the other person. Basically, you are trusting the other person. You are becoming their friend. So like if you are posting something, the other person will be able to see. Similarly, if he's posting something in LinkedIn, I'll be able to see his post or her post. So that's what a connection is. So it's basically a transparent thing. Now, when you follow one person, you will be able to see his posts. Whatever he's doing in LinkedIn, you will be able to see. But then what you are doing will not be shown to him, might not be shown to him. Probably if he's connected to you in some other route, then maybe he can see your post. But if you are following something, usually the other person doesn't seem to be seeing what all you are doing in LinkedIn. Now, coming back to this 0 to 5,000 connections, you have to be very picky for that first 5,000 connections. The reason is the algorithm that LinkedIn is having is something like it tries to give a test dose to the connections that you are having. Say, assume that you are posting something. So what it does is it will share your post. Assume that you are sharing something. It shares your post to your connections, and it will see how engaging that post is in that connection group. So if no one is engaging with that, then LinkedIn might assume that this is something that is not interesting. And LinkedIn, the main aim for LinkedIn is to have a lot of content which is engageable. So if whatever you post is not being liked, or it's not like alone, it's just even reading, if people are not reading what you're posting, then your post will die down. So that is the reason why I said the first 5,000 connections is very, very critical, because you need to have your connections who are engaging with you. Whenever you post something, they read what you post. They probably might interact with your post by commenting on it, adding to your ideas. And unless and until your first 5,000, which is where LinkedIn targets your posts, if they're not able to react to your post, that will be very, bad for your post. So make sure that the first few connections, don't think about the first 5,000, at least the first 100, you have people who are really active, really into LinkedIn. It's not like once in a blue moon they come and then sign into LinkedIn. Have people in your connections who are really active. So that's the reason why I said be very picky here. Don't just add whoever sends you an invite. They might not even be interested in what you're posting. So be very picky there. We'll go a bit more detail into that a little later. So now the importance of connections. As I said, these are the people who give you visibility. So it's basically your maybe platform. So you are kind of relying on your connections to take your ideas to the bigger world. So these are the people who give you visibility to others. Now, your connections determine how visible you get. You means your posts. Now, for example, let's take an example. You are an HR and you have a passion for yoga and dance. So ideally, your LinkedIn will have connections who are a few from the HR background. There'll be a few guys who are from the dance background, and there'll be a few yogis also in your LinkedIn. So what happens is, if you're posting something, say a new idea that you found in HR, what you do is you post that idea in LinkedIn. Maybe LinkedIn might share this post with, say, all the yogis. So when they open LinkedIn, what they say is, hey, I saw this new HR tactic to increase the employee engagement. They'll not be interested in reading that. And whenever you post something, the whole post doesn't go in. Only the first couple of sentences will be visible. Unless and until you click on that see more, you'll not be able to see the entire post. So as a yogi or as a dancer, I don't care about what new tactic that you have found to create more engagement. So, and LinkedIn, what it does is it analyzes how much of engagement your post is getting. And if these yogis or dancers don't even read your post, it doesn't, LinkedIn doesn't care to share it with others. So that, okay, so this is what LinkedIn decides to share your post with others by seeing how engaging your post is. So unless and until it's engaging, your post is not going to go across that boundary of your connections. So make sure that your connections are for a specific cause. So that's the importance of connection. So if you are an HR, if you are in LinkedIn to improve your HR skills, so have your connections, at least the first few of them, as HR partners or something related with HR. Okay, so as I said, so the first few connections you have is critical for your post to be alive. Okay, so I hope that part of connections is clear. Now, target audience. Maybe this is a new concept for you. What do you mean by a target audience? People who are from the sales background or the marketing background might understand what a target audience is. It's the set of people whom you are targeting to push whatever you have for a sale. Similarly, LinkedIn also is having the same thing. So what is a target audience? The target audience is the reason why you are in LinkedIn. So as we discussed earlier, you might be in LinkedIn for, say, searching for a job. So a target audience would be maybe HRs in the companies that you are looking for a job, or maybe other people who are working in that company. So people who can help you get what you want from LinkedIn, that would be the target audience. Now, why should you consider your target audience? It's basically, as I said, as a marketer understands his target audience, we'll also have to understand what a target audience is. What's the importance of it? It's the best audience that you can get. You're looking for a job. The best audience that you can get for your post, say I'm coming up with this new product which can help do these things, or I have gone through this experience in my previous job. I'm really passionate about getting into a job which gives me the opportunity to scale up this particular skill. Those kind of things will be interesting to people who are looking for people like you, which will be maybe HR consultants or Maybe if I'm looking for a person for my team, if I see that, hey, you have done something similar to what I'm looking for, I'm a very good audience for you. So target audience is the best audience for you. So you will have to think about the target audience before you set up your LinkedIn, the environment. Now, the biggest mistake is unawareness of a TA's target audience. I used to have this same problem. Whenever someone had sent me an invite, I would accept it without even looking who it is. So that was one of the biggest mistakes I made in LinkedIn. So what happens is your connections will be huge, maybe 1,000, 2,000. And you might be boasting, hey, I have 5,000 connections in LinkedIn. But most of them might be of no use to you. So that's the biggest problem a lot of people are having with LinkedIn. Be very, very picky with the first few connections. Make sure that the posts that you are making are engaging. Once you have that, maybe that 5,000 milestone, if you cross that 5,000 milestone, you don't really care who else is there, because you already know that there are people in your connection list who will be engaging with your posts. So these are the three things about target audience. And how do you determine your target audience? There are three main questions that you should ask yourself to understand what your target audience is. And it's same for whatever reason you are in LinkedIn, whether it's for a personal brand creation or for a job search or for getting leads. It's basically, who do you help? Who are you? Who are you? And who is the person that you are trying to help? That is the first question that you have to answer. The second one would be, what is the help that you are trying to offer them? How are you help? Not how, but what is the help that you are providing them? We'll go through some of the examples. So, and the third question that you need to ask yourself is, how are you going to help them? So if I take an example, maybe my target audience would be, or when I answer these questions, the statement I come up with be, I help men who are above 40 prepare for a marathon. And there'll be one more part where it says how. I've not put that. So I help men who are above 40. And what is the help that I'm giving them? It's preparing them for a marathon. Okay. Another example could be, I help doctors reach out to rural villages using our video consultation software. So that's a full sentence with all these three questions answered. It's the doctors who I'm going to help. And what is the help? Reach out to rural villages. And how? It's by using our, say, video consultation software. And a third one would be, I help teachers reach more students by taking them online. This is something that most of the teachers would have already done, but this is another statement that I might come up. If I'm a teacher, if I'm a marketer, I can help teachers. Teachers is the target audience. What am I helping them with? I'm helping them with reaching to more students. And how? It's by helping them get online. So I hope you understand the importance of target audience and the reason why you should think about who you are talking to instead of focusing on yourself, instead of focusing on what I do. So that's one main mistake people make. You keep on advertising, hey, this is what I did, this is what I did. They don't really care whether the other person is really interested in reading about what you're doing. Provide things that others need. So that's the target audience. Now, a small difference in how you should think if you are searching for a job is, instead of who you are going to help, it's like, what do you want to do or what do you do? Are you a software engineer? Are you a digital marketer? Are you a software engineer trying to be a marketer? It could be a want to also. So basically, try to answer what you want to become. If you are going to become something different than what you are right now, because you are trying to attract people for your future position. So that's why think about who you want to be. The next question would be, where do you want to work? say maybe you might have shortlisted a few companies, shortlist them and say, okay, fine, I want to be a digital marketer working for Google, working for Facebook. So those, that will be the answer for these two questions. And the third one is, who can help you or who can you impress to get a job there? So maybe you connect with people who are working as HR consultants to that particular company, or have connections, or think about target audience as people who are senior in that company, maybe senior software engineers there, or engineering managers there, or project managers there. So you'll see a lot of profiles shortlisted if you make a simple search in LinkedIn. So this would be the three questions that you should be answering for yourself if you are trying to get a new job or try to improve your current job. Okay, a few tips. Specify whenever you post. Let's take the example that we had earlier. HR, passionate about dancing, passionate about yoga. You can do, even though you have these people in your connections, you can have a subset of your connections see your post. This is a trick that you can do. Even though you have connections, you don't have to remove them. So if you are trying to post something about yoga, you can create a group with all these people in that yoga group, and then say post it only to these people. So LinkedIn will help you create that subset when you post a text or a video or whatever. Now, have connections who are active and engage with your post. How do you know whether they are active? You can't go every day and see what they are doing in LinkedIn, right? So you have something called an activity section. If you go to a profile, if you scroll down, there would be a section called activity. Activity means what is this guy doing, or what has this guy done for the last n number of days. Usually it is 90 days, I think. So you'll see the last four things that he has done. So looking at it itself, you'll understand what kind of engagement is he making with others. Is he sharing new posts? Is he commenting to multiple posts? Is he sharing some other posts? You'll have an understanding of how this person is active there. So that's one tip. The other one is, analyze your connections. Even if you have 2000 connections, there is no point in having 1990 of them who are dormant. Analyze those connections and remove them if it's not a match. If you are having multiple people who are not reacting to your post, engaging with your posts, just remove them. That's the best thing that you probably can do. Okay, the next one is invite new people. Now, you can't just remove and then stay with whatever you have. You have to invite new people. So when you invite, that's basically a connection request. When you request for a connection, you just don't click on that connect button and then send connection. Don't do that. You type something which is personal. I have seen a big difference between the responses I get when I have a personal message, and don't use the personal message that LinkedIn gives you by default. I would like to be a part of your professional network. Please add me. That's the reason why you're connecting, right? Be a bit more personal. Say that, yeah, this is something that we both share. We are both interested in this particular thing that you've been talking about. Or I really liked this post that you had made. I would like to learn a bit more from you. Or I am doing this and you are doing something which is kind of related. Let's understand how we can work together so that we can collaborate and come up with a better product. Those kind of personal invite messages definitely make a big difference in how they think about you and how they react to your invites. So always invite a new person, connect with a new person with a personalized message. You don't have to do a big research and all, at least one or two data points to make sure that they understand that, yes, it's not a machine gun that you are operating. Let it be a sniper thing. You are targeting one specific person. It's not a big mass invite that you are sending. It's specifically to this person. If that person understands that, there's a high chance that he will accept it. And I know in this audience there are a couple of people who have whom I had sent a personal message, and within 1 hour they responded to me back saying that yes, I would like to be a connection. So that has been proven. Now there is a warning. LinkedIn will check the number of invites that you are sending on a daily basis, and if you send more than, I don't know the number, probably 50 or 100, if you cross that, it'll give you a warning, a you are sending a lot of invitations, which is higher than the average. Please stop, don't invite people just like that. And if you still continue inviting more people, there are chances that LinkedIn will say for the next 1 week or 2 weeks, you cannot invite anymore, or maybe you can't even sign in. I don't know what will happen, but it's not something that is pleasant that will happen if you do that. Okay, now you have sent an invite to others. Maybe this is one person you really want to connect and he is not responding. So what you can do is wait for a couple of days, maybe wait for a week. And if this person is not responding, you have an option to withdraw your invitation. You can re-invite. If you go to your profile, if you go to the connections, I think there is a section where you can say pending invites, I think. And there is a button called withdraw. You can withdraw your invitation and then the next day you can connect again. So probably at that point of time when you had sent that connect, he was busy. He did not look at it. The second time you try it, maybe he might accept it. Now, if he doesn't accept it, then probably try getting his attention by commenting on his posts, liking his posts, maybe endorsing some of his skills. Those are the ways in which he'll be able to understand, hey, there is a person who's behind you. So keep following up until they or he or she accepts your invite. And once they accept it, that's another mistake that people would do. They'll bombard that person with all the sales that this person wanted to bombard. Say, assume that you are trying to sell some course. The moment they accept the invite, they'll say, oh, thank you. Now, please join my course. It's only 5,000 rupees. Please do it in 2 days. And then keep on bombarding messages one after the other. That will only make the other person reject you. And probably he will only remove that connection. So don't attack him with your sales skills once he accepts your invite. So that's one tip that you should always keep in mind. Okay, the next one is your profile. Now, you understood what the target audience is. You understand why you are in LinkedIn. Now, let me pause and see whether there are any questions. Priya says, is this to come clear in each content or also critical for the LinkedIn bio? I'm trying to understand that. Is this to come become clear in each content or also critical for a LinkedIn? Priya, I'm not sure whether I understood that question. Sorry. So Soundarya asked how to remove. How to remove? Yeah, I think remove connection is there. There is a button where you can say remove connection. It's simple. I hope you are talking about the remove connection. How will you follow up for a pending request? So you can withdraw. And once you withdraw, I think you will be able to invite him again the next day. Maybe max of 1 week. Not more than that. You can do that. And how many times? I don't know. I'm not sure how many times one can withdraw. I mean the target audience. Okay. Yes. Basically, it is to make it clear how to present to others. Should I be presenting as a job seeker, or should I be presenting myself as a dancer or a yogi? Depending on that, you can understand how your profile has to be. We'll get into the profile now. So it's basically to make yourself clear on how I should present in front of my target audience. So unless and until I understand the target audience, I'll not know how I should be presenting myself. So the target audience is to understand how to present yourself. Yeah. Okay. Any more questions before we go ahead with the profile? Now you understand whom your target audience is. Now, as I said, dress up accordingly. Create your profile not how you want that profile to be, but how others want your profile to be, how others might be looking at a potential person that they can connect to. So your profile gets you the views to people whom you are looking for or who are looking for you, both sides. So if there is a recruiter who's looking for a software engineer who's having a high amount of passion in C++, that's a computer language. So if your profile says, I'm passionate about doing projects in C++, that will definitely get his attention. Now, the main things, the five things that you have to be very clear, and the optimization has to be in these five areas. The first one, definitely, it's your name. I have seen people who have put names without, maybe with typos. I have seen people who have put it with typos, their own name with typos. There are people who have just put it in plain small letters. Normally, that's not treated good. So if you are kind of doing it in that way, that is not something that others will really like. They might think that you're not really serious about your profile. They might not even reach out to you. So make sure that the name is very clear. Okay. The title. So I'll give the examples on how a title should be, the good title, the bad titles, in the next slide. Again, we'll go to what screenshot I have displayed here after I go through all these five. The location, where you are located, the experience, what's your experience, what's your the current experience that you are having, not the whole thing, but currently what are you doing, and the shared connections. Now let's go to this screenshot that I have taken. I don't know these two people personally. I just took a screenshot to show what a person will see when they are looking for someone. Say, assume that I need to market my product. So what I'll do is, in LinkedIn, I'll go in the search box, I'll say digital marketing, and I need people in digital marketing. So a couple of search results that I've got was, one is Varun Vijayaraghavan. And the reason why it came is, see, this is in bold. So LinkedIn will search your current position and see whether the same keyword is there. Even the last one, it's a bit scrolled up, that also had digital marketing in his current role. So the third one also, digital marketing. So this is how a person who's searching for someone, a target, will see the results as. So if you see, these five things are what is displayed here. The name is very clear. No typos, no capital, small letter, mix. The title, growth and digital marketing at BigBasket. So again, when you search for a keyword, it will check whether even your title has that. So here there is digital marketing, and here also digital marketing is there. So that's why these search results came in the first page itself. Location, again, they'll be able to see Bangalore urban. You can also filter your search by saying that I want only people from this particular place. Experience, this is the current experience that he has, digital marketing manager at bigbasket.com. This person doesn't have the current one, that's why it says past is digital marketing and brand consultant at freelance, or the current one doesn't have digital marketing, that's why this person, the last job was not shown here. Now, shared connections, in this case, I have a shared connection with this particular person. So this is why all these five are important. Only if I have enough things here will I go and drill down into this profile. So make this small space, that real estate, as attractive as possible, as full as possible. So make sure your name is very clear. Title, that's very, very important. That's one thing that people don't realize. So make sure that the title, which is here, the growth and digital marketing at bigbasket.com, very, very clear. We'll go a bit deep into that in the next slide. Location. You put the location as what your clients should have. Assume that you are looking for coaching consultations and you're looking for coaches in UK, so don't put it as Bangalore. I think it's okay to say my location, my target location is UK. That's fine, is what I have heard from multiple people. The experience, make sure that you clearly say what your experience is, what your expertise is in, and what you're working as right now. And the shared connections will show up automatically. Now, once someone clicks on your profile, these are the four things that they will look at. One is the summary. What, in say 3 or 4 lines, what are you? They are interested. They got interested by reading this. They want to know a bit more. So the summary has to be crisp. Don't write whatever happened from the day of your birth. Make it very, very simple. What's your real strength? Put it in the summary. Description can be a bit more descriptive. Your passions, your ideas, your thought process, your inclinations, everything can be in that description. Make sure you have a lot of keywords. When I say keywords, this is a keyword. Digital marketing is a keyword. Put a lot of digital marketing words in description. So LinkedIn will kind of grab or search for these kind of keywords and then give you a bit more priority or highlight when it shows the search results. So make sure the description is very clear. It's full of keywords. Don't make it full of keywords just for the sake of keeping it as keywords. Create sentences where automatically that keyword comes into that sentence. Now try to get endorsements, because I mean we all do it online. Whenever you are going to buy a product, you'll see how many ratings it has. So endorsements do the same thing for you. How many people have endorsed you? That is very, very important. Try to get as many endorsements as possible, good ones, review recommendations, those things you have to get from others. That actually increases your probability of being connected to that person or being invited to something by the person who's looking for you. And the featured section. Feature section is a section where you can highlight what you are. You can upload PDFs, you can upload images. So if you have a certification, if you have got a gold medal in MTech or some masters, put it there, take a screenshot of it and then put it in that featured section. So that's basically your banner. That's basically inviting others to, or basically saying that this is what I am, kind of advertising yourself. So that's your profile. Let's go to the title. Going to the title, don't just add a title just for the sake of adding. Don't say digital marketer or engineer, manager. Okay, use the keywords. People will be searching you with keywords. Add those keywords in the title. Now keep it as a sentence. Don't say software engineer. I'll give you a couple of examples which are good, which are bad. So then you'll understand. The bad ones are these ones. Software engineer, Bangalore urban. Okay, good. There are n number of software engineers. As they say, if you throw a stone in Bangalore, it'll either hit a dog or a software engineer. So software engineers are that much in Bangalore. So don't make it so generic here. Or an assistant manager doesn't give you that person any idea of what you actually do. Or there is a great guy who said none. There was none in his title. So it was interesting. Good title would be something like, I help realtors and business owners to acquire 60 to 100 plus new clients every month in whatever. So if I am a real estate agency, if I am into the real estate business, I clearly understand what I get by connecting with this person. If this person is able to help me get 60 to 100 new clients, wow. That's a great thing that I can do by connecting with him. I'll immediately have a connect request. Or I help coaches to get clients and generate profits using the power of sales funnel. So if you are a coach, you will understand that by connecting with this person, you can expect what I can get from him. So these are good titles. So probably you can search LinkedIn and find out sentences. So you see a big difference between this and this, right? So for a software engineer, you can say, I'm passionate about working in projects that are multi-layered in C++ or Java or cloud, mobile applications, iOS, whatever. So make a sentence and have keywords in that. So realtors will be a keyword, business owner would be a keyword, new client would be a keyword. These acquire, that also could be a keyword that people might be searching for. Okay, put the keywords in a sentence which is correct in English. Okay, create a sentence. That's your unique sentence. Okay, so that's about titles. Now pictures. Your profile will have two pictures. One is a professional photo, that small circle that you have, you are shown in that small circle, and something in the background. Most of the people don't know what that background is. People think that it's LinkedIn didn't know what to put there, so they just put something called a banner. Now they put all kinds of colors there. So that's not what you should be doing. So add a cover picture. It's called the cover picture, that big rectangular thing that you have behind your photo, that circle is called the cover photo. Put it as your marketing message. You have understood what you are in the previous slide. The title itself will give you an idea of what your title should be. Use that, create a marketing message for you, and then put a cover photo. Maybe you can put a photo where you are with someone else whom you really admire, or who is something that adds authenticity to your profile. I don't know, I can't take a name, but yeah, if there is a person who is adored by a lot of people, who is looked upon by a lot of people, and you happen to have some acquaintances with him, have taken a photo with him, put that as a cover photo. You basically use his qualities, or his reach to yourself. So that's the power of cover picture. Now I've just taken an example here. So this is the professional photo, very clear. And then here is a cover picture where he says this is his company, I think, and it clearly says HR and management consultant company. Really neat. It doesn't look cluttered. It's very clean. So that's an example. Don't just copy what you see here, but come up with something that is comfortable to your eyes. Okay, now that you have set your profile up, I'll just pause and then see whether any questions. Are people still here? Okay. Target audience, yes. Okay. Amrita, sometimes we may have multiple interests, say dancing and baking. So if you are focusing on two interests at the same time, then should the target audience be people concentrated on both or just one? Ideally, just one. Don't try to target two different audiences. That will actually, as I said, dilute your posts. If you are trying to get more engagements, you never know where LinkedIn will be showing your post. So if you are trying to have baking, then maybe put only baking connections, baking related connections in your profile. Now, once you have enough bakers in your connection, then probably you can have another group where you can say, okay, these are the dance guys. And as I said, when you post it, tell LinkedIn, don't show it to bakers. Don't share your dancing photo to the bakers or vice versa. So that is one thing that you could do. Okay, any more questions before we go to the next slide? What to do after profile setup? Three, two, one. Okay, I've not got anything. Okay, let's proceed. Okay, what to do after the profile is set up? You have a profile, wonderful photo, a great cover photo, great summary, great description with a lot of keywords there. You have a lot of featured things in your profile, a lot of endorsements, a lot of recommendations, everything is there. You are amped up there. Now, what to do? Now, start creating content. There is a option of you inviting others also, which we've already talked about. You invite a lot of other people to be a part of your environment, create that big connection list. Once you have that connection list is what we are going to talk about. Start creating content. And what is a content? Content is something that you create in LinkedIn. You add a post, maybe share a video, share a image, write something on your own, and then post it. That is a content. That's one part of the content. Now treat this as a means to attract people. It basically should tell that, yes, I'm still here. I'm still alive. I'm still kicking. This is what my thought is for today or this week. Ideally, you should post 3 or 4 times a week is what they say. But practically, it might not be possible. At least once a week, like a heartbeat. You just post something, not something, but something of quality. Don't post something because that again would reduce the engagement. Post something that you think really strong about, which is relevant to the target audience, the connections that you have. Treat it as a means to gain attraction from them. Okay, now keep your name. So this is basically, this helps you keep your name at the top of their head. When the people keep on seeing posts from you, the moment there is some opportunity, the first name that they might get is your name. Like I heard one person say that this person was invited for a podcast because this person was posting a lot of things in LinkedIn, and there are lots of people who are silently looking at what we are doing. And as you do this posting consistently, as you engage with a lot of posts, as you engage or create new posts, this will stick in their brain. And whenever there is an opportunity, they'll reach out to you. You never know when they are going to reach out. So be patient, keep on consistently posting in LinkedIn. And LinkedIn algorithm gives you more visibility if you create content consistently. Okay. Now, as I said, there are creating the post, sharing or adding a new post is one type of content. You could create that, or you can create content by commenting on others' post. So assume that you read someone's post and you really liked it and you want to add on to it. You have maybe a different perspective or a different example that you want to give to tell him that, yeah, how aligned our thoughts are. That's another kind of post. So if you are posting it, there is an option to like that also. The comment also can be liked. So as the number of your comments, likes increase, I think LinkedIn will keep the most relevant comments at the top. It's not according to the time. It's the relevant comment. And the relevance of that comment would be most probably the number of likes or the number of engagements others are making to your comment. So these are the two ways of creating content. One, you can start fresh, a new thought, or add on to some other post. Okay, posts can be text, video, or documents. There are different theories where people say videos are the best. Some say no, it's plain text which is the best. Some say documents. You can upload PDFs if you have come up with some presentations. Maybe a PPT can be uploaded, a PDF file can be uploaded. I think a Word document can be uploaded. So in case you want to share something with the whole world, you can share that document also. You don't have to copy paste the content into LinkedIn. Okay, so that's what you should do after the profile is set up. Concentrate on content. We'll keep on talking about content for maybe next 5 to 10 minutes and I'll end. Content, try to have stories in your content because we have that child in us and all of us like to listen to stories. That's why movies are still popular and not documentaries. Okay, so try to have stories because you have a very small limited number of characters that you can type. So try to have it as stories instead of boring theory. So try to see if you are able to add some emotions to it, something that people are able to engage with, able to relate to. Try to have stories in your content. That's one thing. You can share your experiences. I can say last day, this is what happened in my company, and this is how this person reacted, this is what I did, and this is what I learned from it. There'll be a lot of people who might have the same or similar experiences. So they will start engaging with us. Polls, I don't know how. I personally don't like this because a lot of polls doesn't really add value. So personally, I don't like this idea, but since a lot of people are saying, oh, polls are good for engagement. Yeah, for engagement, for just engagements, you can have polls because a lot of people will be clicking on one of those options, especially when one of the option is obvious. A lot of people would select that. That increases your engagement. But I am not a great fan of polls here. Okay. Now, when you post a content, only the first few words are shown. I think I mentioned it earlier also. When you're writing a big story, make sure that the first line is catchy. That's the sentence which makes a person click on that see more. So unless and until the first statement is really attractive, because LinkedIn is having so many posts, and for someone to click on that see more from your post when compared with the other post, you need to have a very, very catchy first statement. Make it the most attractive one. You can probably have it as a subject line of a mail. So when you click on if you have 10 mails, you are most likely to click the mail which attracts you the most, and that's the subject line. So treat that first line as the subject line of a mail. Make it clickable. Okay. And when you create content, don't think about yourself. Don't think how I can show myself as the most intelligent person in this planet Earth. Think about the other person, because they are the ones who are actually doing the work for you. They are the ones who are going to engage with you. So always think about the target audience when you create a content, when you post something. So unless and until it's something that is interesting to them, they're not going to read your post or watch your video. Now, at the end of the post, it's great to have something called a call to action. What is a call to action? A call to action would be something that you do after learning something. You say, okay, fine, with this learning, you are going to do this thing. At least there are people, even I have done that. The last sentence would be, what do you think? Add your comments below. Share your thoughts. Please help me understand this. Something like that. So that question makes the other person, the reader, respond to you. That actually increases your engagement, the engagement to the post. So have a call to action. It could be either engage with this post or something else. Now, a few tips on content. Minimize your contents, because the real estate is very, very small. I think 700, if I'm not mistaken. It's not huge. You can't write an essay there. So make it as crisp as possible. People don't have time. In 2 or 3 minutes, if they are able to read it, yes, your content is going to be read completely and then engage with. Otherwise, maybe they'll stop halfway and then leave for other posts. Don't clutter. Don't create big paragraphs. We used to do it in our school exams or college exams. You create a big paragraph to make sure that the teacher doesn't read through. Repeat the same statement multiple times. Oops, sorry. I'm letting out a few secrets. Sorry. So don't clutter. Don't do that same trick here, because what you need here is not marks. It's engagement. So don't clutter. Make it make the paragraphs easily readable. And don't have 7 or 8 sentences in the same paragraph. Keep enough spaces between them so that you encourage them to read on. Now, use simple language. Don't be Shashi Tharoor. Don't create words that no one else understands. Make it as simple as possible. They're not going to take a dictionary and understand what you're trying to say. They'll just skip, because they're not losing by not reading your post. Make it as simple as possible, as easy to read. Now, make it mobile friendly. With most of the people reading or using LinkedIn in mobiles, make sure they are able to read it in the mobile. Again, the first three, if you take care of it, I think that mobile friendly also will happen automatically. Hashtags. Hashtags are ways in which you can expand your reach. Hashtags, I hope you know it. It's basically a pound symbol and something, some word. So that if there is something trending, that is happening in LinkedIn, you can add that, and that actually amplifies your reach. The posts will get to a larger audience if you add the right hashtags. But don't clutter again your post with hashtags. Our ultimate aim is to reach to multiple people and they engage with it, not just reach them. Okay. Don't add links to your post. Don't say, hey, I have this new YouTube video, please go here, and youtube.com, No. LinkedIn will accept it. It's not going to reject it, but it's not going to share it with others. What I understand is the algorithm sees whether this person is going out of LinkedIn, and LinkedIn will not like a person to go out of that tool to a different site. So any URL that you give, it will reduce the reach of your post. So how do you want to, how do you do that then? That is by adding it in a comment. You tell what you want to say and say in the, see the comment for more details, or see the comment which has a URL to a video. That way LinkedIn will not, I don't know, maybe the algorithm is not that intelligent, but it still shows the post to a large number of people. Now I have an example here. So this is a famous guy. So he did the same post twice, exact same, not exact same, but the same, same message he was giving. So first he said, read about the best new features of iOS 11. Click on the link in the first comment below to know more. So it had around 25K views. Now the same thing he had, and he put a link here. It, even though it says lnkd.in, it's basically pointing to a different site. So LinkedIn would have kind of reduced the reach of this post. So you can see there's only 7,424. It's not because of people not viewing it. It's because people were not shown this post. That's why the number of views is less. Again, the number of likes, again, it's up to the person. When you see the percentages, it's almost the same. So the number of people who might have seen this post is very low. Okay, so that's about contents. Now, again, call to action. As I said, at the end of everything, you need to make the audience do something. Analyze your profile. It's basically a recap of what we discussed. Analyze your profile. See whether that's the best you can come up with. Think about your target audience. Think as your target audience and look at your profile. Will I, as a person, the target audience, be staying in this page for more time? Will I be clicking different links in my this thing? Will I be going through the feature section? Will I go through my description? Analyze in that way. So there are online tools. I was searching for some of the tools that I knew earlier, but I have not got that. I'll probably send the link separately. So there are online tools which are available, which will analyze your profile. So the process is like, you can download your profile as a PDF, and this particular website would accept a PDF LinkedIn profile. Now it will go through different sections of your profile and say that, hey, this section doesn't look good. You should be having this. It will even try to see how many times you have used the keywords. Those kind of things it will analyze. It will take around, say, 2 minutes for it to analyze. But finally, it will say, this is what it is. It's a free tool, so don't have to pay anything for that. So that's one thing. Optimize your profile once you analyze it, once you take it through these online tools. Optimize it according to the suggestions that are given by the website. Use keywords, fill it, don't overdo it. Don't say digital marketer, legit marketer. Don't do that. Make it as a sentence. Put that digital marketer or whatever keyword you have as a smooth flow in that statement. Now analyze your connections again. If you have 2000, that's not something that you can boast unless these are connections who are really helping you. Remove whoever is not required and start writing content. Don't have to wait until you get that perfect idea that you can share with the world. Keep on doing it. Try to do it at least twice or thrice a week. I have not reached that. I'm still at a point where I'm struggling to have one post every week, but I hope to increase the number of contents. So I would suggest you also recommend, push you to write more content in LinkedIn. And the last one is always like, comment my post, engage with my post. So that's what you can give me back if you like this session. So like it, share it, as they say, like, comment, what is it? Like, subscribe, notify, something, right? So do the same thing for my posts also. So that's all I had in the session. I think, yeah, 10 minutes, 10 minutes beyond the time that we had planned for. But let's see, any questions, any comments? How did you feel? Was it worth your time? 1 hour, Friday evening? Yeah, of course, right now you can't go for a boost party, but still, was it helpful? Is anyone here still? Or all of them left? Anyone here? Anyone yet not asleep? 4 people I see. I'd really appreciate if I can get a comment of how you felt. What can I do better to improve it, if at all, if I'm giving it again? Wonderful session, Arvind. Thank you, Priya. Thanks a lot. Yes, it is worth it. Thank you, Priya. Again, Soundarya, great session, Arvind. Thank you. Amrita, yes, it was pretty helpful. Thank you. Soundarya, great session, Arvind. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. I hope it helped. Again, the call to action is what you have to remember. Thank you, Chitra. So unless and until you take action, this hour is not going to be useful to you. Analyze your profile, optimize it according to how you want others to like it. Create content. Optimizing the profile is a one-time job, worth the session. Thank you, Soundarya. And create contents. Don't wait for the perfect perfect idea, perfect thought. Nothing will be perfect. So keep posting. There is nothing that you are losing by posting. So I wish you the very best. Thank you for staying with me.